all, let's see the working of online loom monitoring system. In the loom factory, there will be an admin and a non-admin or n number of non-admin users. If he is an admin, he'll get the following login screen as we can see above. He'll enter his username and password, which will be already created in the application as follows. This is the main screen. In the main screen, we have the following options like the loom status, data administration, reports, and database backup and restore. In the loom status, we show the various kinds of dash panels we have. First dash panel is for the all machines. Second is dash panel for the machine speed. Third is for machine stoppage. Fourth is for machine style. Fifth is for production unit. Let's see the first dash panel, all machine dash panel. In this dash panel, we have all the machines working in the loom factory. Here are the machines. The square block represents a machine with its ID. If it is having any kind of error, it will show here the style. Like this machine is having a power down, while this machine is running with an ID of 101, efficiency, production efficiency, and the machine style. Now, green color of the machine indicates the machine is running, while red indicates the machine is stopped. Overhead, we have a toolbar which shows the total number of machines in the factory, the machines which are running, the machines which are stopped, machines with errors, and overall efficiency. In the right, we have a panel for previous month efficiency, followed by previous shift efficiency and current shift efficiency. If we right click on the machine, we get a pop-up. This pop-up shows the system information plus some graphs like a bar graph, line graph. The graphs represent the machine efficiency based on the previous shift, current shift and the next shift, followed by same by a line graph. In the system information, we have the parameters like the machine number, type, brand, IP, port, RPM. This all is about the dash panel for all machines. Next, we have the dash panel for machine speed. This dash panel distinguishes the machine according to its speed, like it will show the ID, the machine speed, actual speed and the style. Same like all machine dash panel is this the dash panel for the speed. Its next one is the machine stoppage dash panel. In this dash panel, the stoppage occurred in the machine are shown on the machine plus the total. Like here we have the wrap, weft, other and total. In other errors, we can have the mechanical error, electrical error, etc. occurring in the factory. Now next we have dash panel according to the machine style. The machines are distinguished as per their styles. Like here we have four styles already integrated in the software. Now let's go for this style. Now all these machines are having a particular style. According to their style, they are displayed here. Next we have for the production unit dash panel. In this dash panel, we need to select a production unit. A factory can have n number of production units. In one production unit, there can be a particular number of machines. Like in the production unit 1, we have total number of four machines, in which one is powered down while three are running. Here we can see the total number of machines in a particular production unit. Second option is the data administration. In data administration, we have a user admin, machine admin, brands, style, error flag, production unit and shifts. In the user admin, this An admin can create a new user and assign to a non-admin user, like he needs to enter the new user name, his first name, last name, email address and user type. Here we have a create new user. Using this option, he can create a new user, allocate him the type of email ID and all, and type of user admin. He can be, actually he is a non-admin user. In using the create button, we create a new user. Next we have the machine admin. Using this option, he can create a new machine. He needs to enter the room number, means the machine device number, the type of device, the brand of the device, style of the device, its IP port, followed by RPM and SSPD. Using this option, he can create a new machine in the layout and it will be shown in the dash panel. Next comes the brands option. In the brand option, the administrator is allowed to enter a new brand. As we can see here, n number of brands are there. Similarly, he can use the create new brand option, enter a new brand, like we have this, for example, something, enter, we'll get a message, new brand created successfully. Next we have the styles option. In styles, we can configure a new style using the create new style option. Similarly, like rest. Next we have the error flag option. In this, each error will have an error flag. As we can see, 0, 1, 2, 3 are the error flags. Each error flag will be assigned a new color and its description. Like we have 0 error flag with a green color. Its description is machine is running. Similarly, we can add a new error as shown below. Using the create new error flag, we can create a new error. Next is the production unit option. Using this option, we can create a new production unit. As we can see now, here in the factory, there are 3 production units. So, 3 production units are created. Each production unit has a particular number of machines assigned to it. Like the production unit 1 is having 5, 6, 8, 9, 10 number of devices. 2 is having 12, 14. Similarly, 3 is having 16, 19, 20. If we want to add a new production unit, we can use a create new production unit option and create a new production unit. The last option is the shifts option. The shift option is used to configure the shifts in the factory. Like we have, for example, the factory is having 3 shifts and the shifts are configured in the shift administration option. If we want to create a new shift, we can use a create new shift option and select the hours of the timings of the shift. Then we have the report option. We have 3 types of reports: efficiency report, stoppage report, comparison report. Let's see the efficiency report. In the efficiency report, we need to select the duration. The reports are based on the duration, like we have day duration, by week, by month, by quarter, by year. If you want to see the efficiency report according to day, we'll select the day. The date of the day, like example it's first, then we'll select its other parameters: efficiency report based on shift, production unit, sort number, order number, employee number, all we can see by all machines. Now this is the efficiency report by first, by all machines. In this report we can see the pick count has been captured per hour. This is the loom number. Here we have a bar graph option. In this option, we can see the machine efficiency representation using a graph like the bar graph and line graph. Also, we have a pie graph. This pie graph represents the machine efficiency based on the previous shift, current shift, and the next shift. Above, we have the bar graph. Next, we have the line graph over here. Line graph. This again line graph represents the machine efficiency based on the previous shift, next shift, and the current shift. In the last, in the graph, we have the total pick count, stoppage time, total stoppage time, the efficiency, and the production in meters. Also, we have options to convert the report to Excel and to Word. Using the export to Excel, we can convert the report into Excel as follows. Similarly, we can convert it to Word. Let's see the Excel format. Here is the Excel format. We can see the report according to the Excel format. Also, according to the Word, we can see. The other two are the stoppage report and the comparison report. Stoppage report captures all the stoppages in the machine. Similarly, like the efficiency, we need to select it based on the duration. In the stoppage report, we have the device number, for example the loom number here. Then we have the stoppage start time, stoppage stop time, the error description, and the duration of the error. Like the device number 5 have stopped on 26th August at 11:04, and it has restarted at the same day at 12:54. Its description was like machine stop, and it had a duration of 1 hour 49 minutes. At the down, we have a toolbar showing all the total number of errors occurring in various machines like power down, error code, machine stop, etc. etc. The last is the comparison report. Using this report, comparison can be made between the machines based on like we can say two machines can be compared based on their shift, production unit, sort number, order number. Let's see production unit. In our factory there are 3 production units, so according to 3 we can make a comparison report. Here comes the comparison report. The production unit 1 is compared with 2 is compared with 3. In production unit 1 we can see there are total 4 machines, while in 2 there are 2 machines, while in 3 there are 3 machines, plus the efficiency of the various machines is being displayed, the stoppage time, error count. Here also we have the options to import into Excel, export to Excel, and export to Word. As we can see, this is a comparison report. Here comes the last option, that is database backup and restore. Using this option, we can take a database backup and restore it. As we can see here, if we want to create a new database backup, use this option, create new database backup. will get a message created successfully. As we can see over here, the database backup has been taken. Here we get the message created backup successfully. On the overhead also we have two options for logout and change password. If the admin wants to change password or if he is forget his password, he can use this option change password logout. Now this was the information related to an admin. If there is a user who is a non-admin, then he can enter his username, password, which is given by an admin, and he can enter into the application. But he will have only two options, like the loom status and the reports. The same data will get what an admin receives, like all the five dash panels, as we can see over here, plus the three reports. A non-admin user will have only supervision authorities, we can say, or only he can view the data of a factory. No changes can be done by a non-admin user. He can log out this way. This is the working of the online loom monitoring system.